Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. So in the previous session we have discussed about mechanism of missile formation. That is one of the concept, very important concept. There we discussed about by considering soap solution. Example, I considered sodium stearate. Okay, so if we did in detail, we have analyzed mechanism of missile formation. Now in this session we are going to consider the next concept, or you can say the continuous part of the chapter. It is preparation of colloidal solutions. Next concept is the preparation of colloidal solutions. Yes, how we know about colloids. Okay, again we also considered the types of colloids, and even we considered the mechanism at missile formation. One type of colloid, associated colloid, or I can say missiles, how those missiles will be formed. Well, now we are looking for preparation of colloidal solutions, or I can say colloids. Yes, whenever if you consider preparation, yes, here we can notice there are two ways. As I specified here, one is chemical method. So one is chemical method of preparing colloidal solutions, and another one, there is one more way of preparing colloidal solution, that is physical methods. Okay, so here colloidal solutions can be prepared by two methods, physical methods. So yes, colloidal solution can be prepared by two ways. One is chemical method and another one is physical methods. Well, in this session we try to understand the chemical methods of preparation of a colloids. Well, when I think of chemical methods, then there would be some chemical reactions which takes place during the preparation of a colloids, right? Well, if I consider chemical method, say here the colloidal solutions, what I'm specifying, the colloidal solutions can be prepared by chemical reactions, leading to the formation of molecules. Okay, leading to the formation of molecules. Molecules means what type of molecule here? Colloidal molecules. Okay, colloidal molecules. Colloidal molecules means, once again, what is to be remembered here? Size of the particle, 10⁻x⁹ meter to 10⁻⁶ meter. Or you can say 1 nanometer to how much? 1000 nanometer. Okay, well, here what happens, the colloidal solutions can be prepared by chemical reactions leading to the formation of molecule, leading to the formation of molecules by, what are the ways? Either the colloidal molecules may be formed by double decomposition. Okay, double decomposition. Those molecules may be formed by oxidation, those molecules may be formed by reduction, or those molecules may be formed even by hydrolysis. Which means here, what are the chemical reactions which leads to formation of colloids? It may be double decomposition, it may be oxidation, it may be reduction reaction, or it may be hydrolysis. So by which there will be formation of a colloidal molecules. So well, if I consider chemical methods of preparation of colloids, this chemical methods involves how many examples or how many types? There will be four types, right? Four types. What are those? First one you said, double decomposition. Second one, oxidation. Third one, reduction. And the fourth one, hydrolysis. Okay, by any of these ways colloidal solutions can be prepared. Well, we discuss one by one. What is the first one we said? Double decomposition. First one, you know, double decomposition, by which a colloidal solution can be prepared. Well, here double decomposition means, say here, double decomposition, here the molecules, okay, molecules, say for example, later we'll consider, see here R1 and R2, these are the reactants which gives a product, or I can say product molecules. Okay, R1 and R2 are the reactants. Here during double decomposition, what happens? Both the reactant molecules undergo decomposition. Okay, both the reactant molecules undergo decomposition, and there involves exchange of species between the reactant molecules. First, all reactant molecules. Say, or you can say both the molecules undergo decomposition, they decompose. Okay, first they decompose. Next thing, once they decompose, there involves the exchange of reactant species between the reactant species, exchange of part of the reactant species in between reactant molecules. Therefore, we say a double decomposition. Well, here we understand the meaning of double decomposition with an example. Well, what is the example I specified here? Arsenic sulfide sole. Okay, what is the name of the sole? Arsenic sulfide sole, As2S3. Say As2S3, arsenic sulfide sole. This arsenic sulfide sole can be prepared. How we can prepare means by passing hydrogen sulfide, H2S, by passing hydrogen sulfide gas to arsenic oxide, As2O3. Well, we look at the reaction here. Say, when I consider double decomposition, as I said, reactant molecules, first reactant and second reactant. Say, if they undergo double decomposition, what happens? Both the molecules undergo dissociation, say A, B, A plus B minus, similarly say C plus D minus. Now, what happened here? Both the molecules, first reactant molecule, second reactant molecule, both undergo dissociation. Further, there involves the exchange. Okay, there involves the exchange of species. So it leads to formation of a product molecules. So AD and CB. So here what happened? B is exchanged with C. So resultant will be CB. And similarly, D is exchanged with A. So there will be formation of a AD. Well, if you consider the reaction equation regarding preparation of arsenic sulfide, so what we said, when we pass when we look at the reaction, say when we pass hydrogen sulfide gas to arsenic oxide, say we look at the reaction, say arsenic oxide to arsenic oxide, what we are passing? Hydrogen sulfide gas is passed. So on passing, what happens? There involves a double decomposition reaction. So here on double decomposition, what is the product formed? There will be formation of a arsenic sulfide sole. A colloidal sole will be formed. And what is the another byproduct? Yes, there will be formation of a water molecule. So when you look at the reaction equation, yes, arsenic oxide, we are passing hydrogen sulfide gas. So when hydrogen sulfide gas is passed through arsenic oxide, yes, there involves a double decomposition. So it leads to formation of arsenic sulfide sole. Okay, whatever the sole particle formed. Okay, here size of the particle is in the range of 10^-9 meter to 10^-6 meter. Therefore, the resultant mixture, or against the product formed, is considered as a colloid. Well, so it's an example for double decomposition. Well, second one, we said oxidation. Yes, what do you mean by oxidation here? So oxidation can be defined in different ways, right? So we say addition of oxygen, right? Addition of oxygen is called oxidation. Second way is removal of hydrogen is also called oxidation. And third one, increase in the oxidation state or oxidation number is also called oxidation. And the fourth one, regarding electronic concept, what we say? Okay, loss of electron is also called oxidation, right? We can define oxidation in four ways: addition of oxygen, removal of hydrogen, then further increase in the oxidation number or state, or loss of electron is also called oxidation. Yes, here I will consider the one way of defining, that is loss of electron, or I can say increase in the oxidation state is called oxidation. Well, during oxidation also, yes, we can prepare colloidal solution. So yes, colloidal solution can also be prepared with the help of oxidation reactions. Example, well-known example for oxidation method is preparation of sulfur sole. Okay, preparation of a sulfur sole. Well, how we are going to prepare sulfur sole means, say sulfur dioxide, if you pass hydrogen sulfide gas, when H2S gas, hydrogen sulfide gas is passed through aqueous sulfur dioxide, resultant will be sulfur soap. Well, so here first we look at the reaction. CSO2 sulfur dioxide, we are passing hydrogen sulfide gas, so resultant will be a sulfur soap, and water molecules will be formed. So here, as I said, here oxidation. So here oxidation means there must be that changes must happen. What we said, addition of oxygen must take place, or else loss of hydrogen, okay? Or else in another way, what we can say, increase in the oxidation state, or else we can say loss of electron. So well, what we observe here, say hydrogen sulfide soul. Here, what is the oxidation state of sulfur? -2. Okay, oxidation state of sulfur is -2. Now, when you look at the oxidation state of sulfur in the product, what is the oxidation state? Here it is a 0. Means what happened here? -2 to 0. Yes, there will be increase in the oxidation state, or you can say there will be loss of electron. Means S2 minus is converted into S by losing 2 electron. Sulfide ion. Okay, sulfide. S2 minus means sulfide. This sulfide ion is get converted into sulfur by losing 2 electrons. Therefore, we say it is a oxidation process, and the resultant product formed is a collide. Okay, well, remember, if I consider oxidation method of preparation, example preparation of a sulfur soap. How sulfur soap is prepared? When hydrogen sulfide gas is passed through aqueous sulfur dioxide gives a sulfur soap. Reaction equation is given here, right? Well, what is the next method? Say sulfur dioxide, hydrogen sulfide, we said sulfur soap. That is the resultant product form will be a colloidal soap, right? Well, coming to the third one, what we said, okay, reduction method. Again, reduction means say, again we can say here, reduction means, as like oxidation means, we said addition of oxygen, right? Opposite reduction, loss of oxygen, or I can say removal of oxygen is called reduction. Second, addition of hydrogen is called reduction. Okay, addition of hydrogen is called reduction. And third one, decrease in the oxidation state or oxidation number. Decrease in the oxidation state or oxidation number is called reduction, or gain of electrons is also called reduction. So again, here also reduction can be defined in four ways: loss of oxygen, addition of hydrogen, decrease in the oxidation state or oxidation number, or I can say gain of one or more electrons is called a reduction. So yes, reduction, we can say this is the gain of electron or decrease in the oxidation state or oxidation number is called a reduction. Well, here with the help of reduction method also one can able to prepare the colloidal solutions. Well, a well-known example for this is a preparation of a gold soap. Okay, preparation of a gold soap. Well, how gold soap is prepared means, say here we are going to treat gold chloride, AuCl3, aram chloride is treated with a formaldehyde, HCHO. Okay, say when gold chloride is treated, aram chloride is treated with formaldehyde, resultant will be gold soap. Well, we look at the reaction equations. Okay, say aram chloride, AuCl3, gold chloride, when treated with the aqueous formaldehyde, okay, resultant will be gold soap. Gold soap will be prepared. Yes, when you look at the reaction, say gold chloride, HCHO, formaldehyde, aqueous, that is water, it undergo reduction. Say why we are specifying reduction means, say when you look at the oxidation state of gold here. So what is the oxidation state? Gold is present in +3 state, right? In aram chloride, gold is present in +3 state. But in soap, what is the oxidation state? It is 0. So +3 to 0, what happened here? There is a decrease. How? By gaining Au3+, by accepting 3 electron get converted into Au. Okay, here there is a decrease in the oxidation state, plus 3 to 0, or I can say is going to gain 3 electrons. Therefore, we say the reaction is reduction and the sole formed is the gold salt. Well, if I consider aurum chloride, that is gold chloride, and treated with the methanol, or I can say formaldehyde, it undergo reduction to give gold salt. And what are the byproduct here? Formic acid and hydrochloric acid are the byproducts. Well, the fourth one, what we said, hydrolysis. Fourth one is hydrolysis. First we considered double decomposition, second oxidation, third we considered reduction. Now the fourth method is the hydrolysis. Here, what is the word here? Hydrolysis. How the hydrolysis? So here, usually lysis means breakdown. Lysis andre eno breakdown anta kodutte. Hydro, that is water. Andre a chemical decomposition or a decomposition of reactant species takes place by addition of water. So just remember hydrolysis. So just by, as per analogy, to understand better, hydrolysis, usually how we can remember, it is the breaking of chemical bonds. Now in it will now breaking of chemical bonds, breaking up chemical bonds by addition of water. Well, it means yes, during hydrolysis also one can able to prepare a colloidal salts or colloidal solutions. Well, example for this, example for preparation of colloidal solution by hydrolysis is preparation of a ferric hydroxide salt. Yav salt prepare madodu? FeOH taken twice, ferric hydroxide salt. Well, how ferric hydroxide salt is prepared means, say ferric chloride, we know FeCl3, say aqueous ferric chloride. See here, ferric chloride on hydrolysis gives, gives ferric hydroxide salt. So ferric chloride on hydrolysis, say what happens? It will be undergoing reduction process itself, but it is a hydrolysis. So there will be formation of ferric hydroxide salt and a hydrochloric acid will be formed. So ferric chloride on hydrolysis, when treated with water, warm water, resultant will be ferric hydroxide salt. It is a colloidal salt. Yes, these are the four methods of preparing colloidal solutions. That is, what type of methods they are? They are the chemical methods of preparing colloidal salts, right? Well, now coming to the MCQs, just first one, red sole of ferric hydroxide can be prepared by red sole of ferric hydroxide. How it is prepared? What is the chemical method involved here? Is it oxidation, hydrolysis, reduction, and the fourth one, double decomposition? Yes, what is the answer here? Hydrolysis is the answer. Well, then the second one, sulfur sole can be obtained by sulfur sole. Yav method in the prepare martivi? Yes, oxidation, hydrolysis, reduction, and double decomposition. Yes, how sulfur salt is prepared? What is the answer? Oxidation. What we said here, when hydrogen sulfide gas is passed through aqueous sulfur dioxide, result will be sulfur salt. So here oxidation is the reaction. Well, so with this I am going to conclude about this session. Again, in the next session we continue the rest of the part. Thank you. Be safe.